Hey, good morning. Anybody out there? Not yet.
Can you see that?
Can I see it? Yeah, I can see it. A little bit. Uh-oh. Shit.
You need that, Angel? You need this?
Hello. Good morning. Good morning. We're getting ready to go. Well, we're live. We're getting ready to get started in a few minutes with our total body strength. Hey, Cindy. Are you working out with us too? Are you watching? I hope you're working out with us. Gail, good morning. I hope everybody watching is working out, not just sitting there having coffee. Are y'all getting up and gonna work out with us?
Shake your heads.
Say yes, give me a thumbs up. Let me know what's going on.
Hey,
JoJo. JoJo, you out there? At work, working out. Perfect, perfect. We're about to get started real quick, guys. This is gonna be a total body workout. What time do we have?
What do you want us to put a watch on?
I think I put my watch on circuit. So if you're wearing a Polar or Apple Watch and you're able to put it on a circuit type training or workout, that's what I would set it for. Hey, Jerry. We're about to get started here. So. I think it's right about 8:30. Okay, guys, good morning. My name is Angel. I am group exercise and personal trainer here at Cross Gates Family Fitness. I have, in a very social distance, Greg in the background, so I'm super excited to train him. Our workout today, total body strength, is gonna be a Tabata style training. So if you're not familiar with Tabata, Tabata is 20 seconds of work, 10 seconds of rest, repeated 8 times. A lot of people are familiar with it, a lot aren't, and that's fine. But the idea here is to work for that 20 seconds, earn that 10 seconds of rest, and go at it again, okay? I'll coach you through the moves, I'll even show you modifications. We'll go ahead and get started with the warm-up. Greg, are you ready?
I'm ready.
I'm ready, too. Okay, so hope your watches are on. And if I'm not mistaken, this is also set for later playback, okay? So if you miss something, don't worry about it, you can play it later and you can do the workout later, okay? Plus we have a schedule where this also is a class later on tonight with a little different flair, so you can come back and do it again tonight, all right? Let's go ahead and get started. So to warm up, let's just go ahead and get started side to side. We call this a boxer shuffle. We're just warming up and getting loose. I don't know about you, but I haven't really been moving like I should since Monday night, so I need to get warm as much as you do, okay? Next, we're gonna go into a squat. We're gonna take our fingertips to the ceiling, thumb to the back, overhead squat. We're gonna sit back and down, down and up, sit back into the heels. We're gonna do this about 15 times. I think I'm on 3. Greg, don't trust me. I lose count sometimes. I think it's 5. What you on? 6.
I'm a follower.
Okay, good. 7. So if 7 turns to 15, that's okay. All right, let's keep going. Already starting to breathe a little bit heavy. How about you? So I see comments, but I can't really see them, okay? So trust me.
I'll read them out.
Teresa's here. She'll read them if we have anything to address, okay?
Working
out. Good.
Get it, Greg Johnson.
Yep. Excellent. Good. Now, we want to go ahead and get some lateral movement in. So go ahead and bring the feet to heels underneath the hips. I'm going to lat lunge to one side and lat lunge to the other side. So when you lunge, push the hips back, the knees behind the toe. All right, your chest is lifted. So sometimes I see toes going out at an angle. Just make sure that it's kind of where, don't fall, Angel. Like a 90 degrees, right? Here, when you sit back, rather than going out at an angle. Greg, how you feeling?
I'm good, my legs are awake.
Legs are awake, good. Ah, nice deep breaths. Greg, I plan to work you harder than me.
See ya.
Good. Guys, now I want to go into some soldier kicks, okay? Opposite band to opposite toe. We'll do these on the spot. I like to move with them, but I have a square. So we're just going to do these right here on the spot. Well, they can't. They're in their living room. They're in their cubicles. They're sneaking a workout in.
I'm going to turn up the
music.
A little bit, yeah, that's fine. How are we feeling? If you're wondering, I lost count. But you gotta trust me that we're doing it right. All right, so next I'm gonna go ahead and get that upper body warm. We're gonna do that with the inchworm. I'm gonna turn to the side. Get inchworm, heels underneath the hips. Reach down to the toes, and then walk out hand in hand into a plank position. Walk back into the toes, okay? And come to rise. Let's do a few more of those, okay? Walk out to plank. Good. If you need to modify, guys, it's okay to walk out to the knees. So when you get here, drop to the knees, and then walk back in, okay? Can we do about three more of these? Good. Start to feel the shoulders and the chest. I think we have two more. I know somebody out there is so happy to see me doing this and not just coaching it. Hand-to-hand team training and 5 a.m. clients. Good. Feel good. Roll the shoulders a little bit. Back and forward. Give me a few warm circles. And let's go ahead and just get the blood flowing a little bit and give me 20 straight arm jacks. Is that cool? It looks like this. Modify. Reach to the ceiling. Tap the toes out to the side, okay? Greg, are you counting? Greg, stop counting. So you have to trust me. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. That's our warm up. Anybody sweating? I'm sweating. Listen, we're going to go ahead and get started with the Tabata style workout. The first move will be squat. So the squat is here, body weight, down and up. It's 8 cycles. So if you want to increase the intensity from a regular squat, you can make it a squat pulse. You can even make it a squat hold. Or pulse for the 20, hold for the 10. Okay, so you're at home, but I can't really see what you're doing. We will get some recommendations here, but I'm ready to get started. You ready? All right, our first move. And I've got already time. All right. Deep squat, yes. Awesome. And the timer's on, let's go. And we're working. This is cycle one or round one. We're doing a mid-stand squat, sitting back into the heels. And we're just moving, warming up the quads, okay? Now, we're doing body weight. If you're at home, hold. We're on a 10-second rest. I don't know if that's any way to turn this up. Okay. But I can hear it. You gotta trust me. And we're going again, body weight squats. If you have equipment at home and you want to incorporate a dumbbell or a kettlebell or your bottle of water, gallon that is, go ahead and use that, right? We want everybody to be successful at home, so that's why we're using the body weight to show that we can get a good workout, rest. All right, starting to feel heart rate coming up. I am going to do squat pauses. Greg, stay with the single. Sounds good. And round three, let's go. I'm not sure why I suggested doing this. No, I want to motivate somebody out there. I don't know about you, but it's starting to burn. Anybody doing this also right now? And rest. Who says you can't get your heart rate up with strength work? And pause this again. Let's go. Remember, options. You can do full range single squats. You can do squat pauses. You can pause and then stand. And then pause and stand. Any combination, any variation. I want you to feel challenged. And rest. I'm gonna do the 10 second hold. Uh-oh, can I walk it? If I was a groover. Let's go, guys, we're working again. 20 seconds, let's go. I gotta keep our mind off of the pain, so did anybody catch the pop-up groove last night? OMG, it's out there. I heard people were doing it at the park last night. What? Hold, rest. I'm sweating.
What round?
I don't know, trust the timer. And let's go again. If you're just joining us, we're in total body workout. We're doing a Tabata style strength workout today. Using body weight, but at any time, you can throw in equipment if you have it. Greg wants to know what round we're on. Rest, guys. Anybody out there taking the option? Two rounds left. Ready? Let's go again. I don't know, the music makes me wanna get low, but that's not the prescription. Look at Greg Paulson. Go, Greg. Are you feeling the burn or the quad? Greg, how you feeling?
Yeah.
Okay, thanks. I know y'all worried about him back there. He wasn't answering. Oh, rest. Where's that heart rate? Good.
I'm at my max.
And let's go again. Hi, guys. Come on in. Put the coffee down. Get up in your living room. And let's do it. Do it from the phone. Use your iPad. Project it to the TV if you can. Let's just move. It's over. Go ahead. You can stretch a little bit. Catch your breath. Grab a sip of water. Number two, guys. Take a look here. It's a little different. We just did these squats, and we did the squat pause. I want you to bring your feet a little bit outside of that mid stance. So if you're here, heels are the hips, go heel to wider. Come down, take squat. Two pulses, and then we call this a bear crawl on the spot. So hold over, walk out, and then walk back into your squat. Pulse, pulse, walk out to a bear crawl, walk back in. We're all doing this on the spot. This is gonna burn, but so much fun. Are you ready? You got it? All right, guys. The timer is going on now. Oh, I like it. Oh, come on. Technical difficulties.
We'll take
a break. Okay, here we go. Get low, two pulses and squats. Walk out. It's not a full plank. There's a tilt through the hip. Imagine if we were on the floor doing bear crawls. The butt's kind of up a little bit. Okay? Walk back into that double pulse and squat. Now, how can we modify this? Oh, right here. You do not have to do the bear crawl. If you want to do the double pulse and squat and stand, that's a modification. Okay? All right, here we go. Here we go. Double pulse. Walk out. Damn, already starting to sweat. And walk out. Much needed and wanted. I'm turning to the side. Double squat. Walk out. You can feel the quads here. The shoulders are being engaged. The chest is being used. Yes? Already starting to breathe a little bit heavier. And we're working. Double pulse. Walk out, walk back in, all right? I think this is perfect, especially if you're working out at home and you're in a confined space, right? So, like maybe your garage, maybe the living room, maybe the foyer, I don't know, but I'm glad you're joining us and you're doing it with us, okay?
We got a lot of kids working out with us.
Good, awesome. Good morning, everybody, let's go. Double pause, walk out. They're like, this is a new move. I've never seen this before. This angel's so creative. Okay? Let's go out. Now, if you're moving faster, that's fine. It's just make sure you're being safe. Me? I'm kind of conserving my energy because I know what's coming up next. I'm joking. Joking. 3, 2, 1. Let's go again. Okay. So, I don't know about you, but I've been doing a lot of Netflix and Hulu this week, and I can really feel the benefits from this after being on the sofa for so long. Have you watched anything?
Me?
Good. Oh.
I've been working here.
Thank you for that. 3, 2, 1. Ready to go again? Let's go. Double pause. Walk out. Oh, look at that. Double, double, out.
Oh.
Your range of motion is your range of motion. Don't try to overextend it. Is it over yet? I don't know. Two more, y'all. Two more. Let's go. Two more rounds. We got this. Walk out. Oh. If you're like, my legs are on fire, I have an answer for that. Oh. Is that one more? One more. My answer is, the next move, we take it on the leg. Let's go, last time. Gregory, I like it like that. Oh, it's over. It's over. Hey guys, not sure where you are. We are going to push-ups next. We're on the floor. Now, if the floor is not an option for you, you can use the wall. You can use tabletop kneeling and on the toes, okay? You wanna grab a mat. Also, we are, for advanced options, gonna add the shoulder tap, okay? We'll start off with a basic push-up, and then to make it harder or to intensify it, push-up, tap, push-up, tap. On the knees, on the toes. You ready? Okay. Greg, are you sweating? Okay. All right, good. Glad to make sure. All right, later. And if you're ready, here we go. Hands just outside the shoulders. We're gonna start on the knees here. Chest elbow height. We're pushing the ground away. Flat back, straight head, neck alignment. Again, you can come here to tabletop. You can even come up to the toes here, okay? All options. I want you to challenge yourself, rest. I'm not even counting reps, but if you want to count the reps to see how many you get in 20 seconds and beat that the next time, challenge yourself. Ready? Here's that option. Push up, tap the shoulder. Push up, tap the shoulder. This is to make it more challenging, okay? This can be done on the knees or the toes. I just ask that you don't drop the head like this and keep a straight head neck alignment. I gaze ahead of you about 2 to 3 feet. Oh, rest. If you need to stretch in between, come back to a stretch. Need more challenge? Hold plank for 10 seconds. That's insane. Go! Try doing push-ups to walk. When you really want to like walk and dance. This makes it harder. Brace the core, guys. A push-up a day keeps the doctor away. Have you heard that too? You made that up, Angel. I did. Starting to feel the chest, the shoulders burn. Greg?
Oh, yeah.
You have to see, I keep asking Greg, how's he doing back there? Ready? Let's go. Try the shoulders. Push up and tap. Push up and tap. You can do it modified. This is the tabletop option. You can do it against the wall. I've seen that option. And rest.
Y'all making a sweat rain.
Right? Let's go again. Okay, so you're like, Angel, I'm getting tired, I need something. Pause it. Pause it. Is there one way to challenge your strength? Absolutely not. Here we go. Add the pulses as an option. Woo! I might have stopped a second early. Hey, how you doing? You're like, what did I sign up for? Let's go. Keep breathing and keep pushing. Are they doing it with us?
I think so.
Are they watching us torch ourselves? They like that, huh?
Their final revenge.
They like to see this. Woo! Ready? And go. Three. We have 9 seconds left. Anybody want to add a pulse here? Let's go.
Let's go.
Pulse it. Pulse it out. How many can you get in? Let's go. One more round. One more round. And let's go. Singles for 10 seconds. And then we'll pulse it out for the last 10 seconds. I mean minutes, seconds, sorry. They're like, what are you talking about? And go, pulse it. Bring it up, let's go.
Come on, come on.
It's over. Is it 8:30? Nope. Is it 9? Not yet, almost. 8:50. Stretch out the chest. Good. Move those mats to the side. We're going to take it back to the legs. Back to the legs. I love it. Okay, so listen. Lots of options for this. We call this a pogo leg to lunge. Watch first. Here. Pogo. Here. All right, so arm, opposite knee. That leg goes back to lunge. You touch the floor, or you just lunge back and reach, okay? How do we make it harder? Up and down. Up and hop. So there's a no hop, there's the hop. I'm gonna start with the no hop, and then I'll make my way to the hops, all right? So we'll stay on the same side for cycle one, and then we'll switch legs for cycle two. So we'll go back and forth. Okay, so you get 4 rounds on this leg, 4 rounds on this leg. Okay, thanks.
It's getting better
right
now. Yeah, it is. We are sweating it out of here. In case you're wondering, we didn't spray ourselves with a spray bottle. All right, I always wonder if presenters spray themselves.
They oil up.
They oil up? We didn't oil up, I promise you. This is, you watching real time here. Ready? 3, 2, 1, it looks like this. This is modified. Opposite knee.
Woo!
All right, single leg. To add intensity, add a hop. To add more intensity, reach and lunge for the floor. Your glutes are gonna be on fire. Rest. So we were here, now we're here, all right? So I'm trying not to use right and left because I don't want to confuse anybody, I don't want to confuse me. But you're on the opposite arm, opposite leg now. Here we go. You can reach a little higher. You can jump a little higher. Your glutes are gonna thank you tomorrow. Your quads should be on fire right now. If you can touch the floor.
This is my song.
I knew you would be here. It's rest, y'all. We're on the other side now. Ready? Let's go. Up and reach. Can you feel the burn through the quad glutes? Can you reach towards the floor? And then maybe go a little further. Next time. Rest. Let's switch. Ready? And we've switched. You're here. Brace the core. Reach back as far as you can. And if you can touch the floor, touch the floor. If you can add that hop on the foot that's grounded, that's gonna create more of a challenge. Switch. Notice we were dancing last time. We're not dancing now. Ready? Let's go. Trying to reach for the ceiling tiles. Engage the calf. Greg is showing the option in the background. I hope you can see it. Breathing heavy.
Balance exercise.
Balance. balance and strength. Ready? We're on the other side now. Regardless what modification you're doing, you're still getting benefits from it. Do you agree?
Yeah, y'all.
One more each side. Notice breathing. Ready? Just keep leg going up. Up and down. This is my last time. So we're gonna try to push through a little bit more. Push through the burn. My body will thank me later. I'd love to see how you feel about this later. Awesome. Last time, y'all on the side. Let's go. Push through. Greg is showing you a slower modified option in the back. Remember, modifications don't mean easy. We all challenge ourselves differently. And it's still a tough option. Notice, I'm not even touching the floor anymore. I'm on fire. Oh my gosh, it's over. Anybody need a water break? I do. We're back to the floor. Say what? Yeah. Let me show you. They call it a sit out or sit through. It's challenging, but there's lots of options. Catching my breath. Okay, here's the move. And here are some options, okay? So I'll turn to the side for this one. Sit through or sit out. You're just here kind of in that bare position. My feet are moving. I want to put them on the mat. You're gonna twist, okay? And twist. The sit through ultimately, let me get a mat so I don't slip. The sit through ultimately, your hand is on the shoulder and your leg extends. We're not touching, okay? Don't touch me, Greg. Okay, so ultimately, I hope you got the water, guys, for your sit through. You're here. Either here, see my hands on the shoulder, my legs extended, or I can reach for the toe. So from here to here to here and even here. I showed you like four different ways to do it. All right, start easy and build your way up to options. Progress into it. You ready? It's the same move, all 8 cycles or 8 rounds. All right, pressing the timer. 3, 2, 1, there we go. I'm gonna start here where there's a twist. Wrist under the shoulders. Work in the obliques. Work in the waistline. Twist. Rest. So that's option one, level one. You can stay right there. I'll show you. Here we go. When we twist, we touch. We twist, we touch. Twist, touch. Twist. Opposite. You're doing opposite. You're doing it. So, let's see. When you twist, this hand, this toe. Opposite. Opposite. Kind of like a soldier kick, but we're on the floor. Okay? Here we go. Again. Twist. Start with the shoulder tap. Shoulder tap. After the shoulder tap, extend and extend. Still tapping the shoulder. When you're ready, reach. Put a toe here. So, I don't know my right left anymore. This is my left arm, this is my right foot. So, it's opposite. You got it?
I understand it's hard.
You are doing it though. You're doing it. Watch. Go ahead. It's time to work. It's time to work. The time is over. You're doing it though. Guys, you're still twisting.
I'm not sure I'm gonna do that.
We're gonna do that.
You're doing it.
That's it.
Okay. You got it.
Hey!
Go, Greg.
I know it's confusing. That's why I say start with the level one until you can get it. It's a hard move, it's not easy.
Yeah.
But it challenges your strength, right?
I think a good cue is it's always the top arm.
It's always the top arm, correct. Look, if in doubt, just hang here, catch your breath, knees up, and twist. Always go back to level one. Do you like saying I struggle too? Let's get the bodies, let's go.
I've been done, had that body.
Oh, yes you do. It's not fast. It's slow and controlled. How's everybody feeling out there? Any feedback yet? Any feedback? They're working, right? Let's go. Twist. Gaitlin, I promise you, you're working. I promise. I'm in the red.
Tell her I'll text her what mine was.
Let's go, guys.
Okay.
Remember, you can still leave that heel on the floor. You don't have to lift the foot up. So that's what we're calling the sit through or the sit out. If you can get that foot extended, if you can touch the toe, great. Next week, maybe. Okay, we gotta progress. It's over. Whoa, towel off. Grab a sip of water if you need it. How are we doing on time, T?
We are at 9:01.
9:01, perfect. Guys.
Tell us how many rounds we're gonna do. How short you
are. 1, 2, 3. 4 more Tabatas. You asked.
Guys,
we got 4 Tabatas, yeah, all 4.
You guys are keeping us motivated.
Guys, next is a reverse plank. Say what? What's a reverse plank? And I'll show you some modifications. All right, so sit on the butt. Sit on the elbow. Fingertips, turn towards the butt. Come onto the heels and raise up. That's your reverse plank. How do you make it harder? Well, that's hard. But to make it harder, you can raise the legs. You're gonna feel the triceps annihilate, okay? It's a tricep move. You're gonna feel the quads, you're gonna feel the glutes. I don't even know if I can last 20 seconds, to be honest. Modified, we can do 4 dips, okay? Or if you're somewhere in the house, sofa, table, or chair, you can't see me, and you can do some dips. You can do dips. You can totally do dips of furniture, or turn, lost my board. Or turn our fingers towards the butt, and just like I showed you on the floor, lean back, bend in the elbows, okay? Let's annihilate the triceps. Who's in for that?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Here we go. You can also come here and modify this lift, right? And then as you progress, walk those feet out, lift the butt.
Whoa.
And just hang here. Just hang. Remember what I said if you want more?
Kelly Riggs said, we are working, Angel. Woo!
That's a calf burner.
Ready? Lift the butt. You're here. Or walk those legs out. Squeeze the butt. Just look to the ceiling, guys. All you have to do is hang here. You can add the leg lifts. Lift those hips. Rest. Ready? Modify here. Fingertips towards the butt. Bend the elbows. You're still gonna work the triceps. Greg, how you feel?
Harder.
Has anybody tried lifting a leg yet? I did, and my triceps started screaming on the first leg lift. Ready? We're going again. I stopped a second early. Why are we breathing so heavy and we're just hanging here? Ready? And lift. Can you bend the knees and march and still get a workout? Yes. Hey. What, Angel, what if I need to rest? Look at here. Lift and down. Lift and down. Guess what? That tricep will still be engaged. Ready? Let's go. When my wrists are starting to hurt, okay? Stretch them. And then here, modify. It's high here. Heart rate still up, and we're doing strength work. We're not even doing cardio. That's what they're probably saying. But you can still burn calories in this strength. I was like, because we're just hanging? Lift your butt up. Thank you. You can feel your hamstrings. Your glutes, your triceps. I surely hope there's nothing hard after this. Anybody sweating yet? Go ahead, stretch the tricep. If you did not feel this through the tricep, guys, next time, just kind of look where your hand positions were. You really want to try to get those fingertips in towards the butt, okay? Next move, and don't be all alarmed because it has the word burpee in it. It's a half burpee, okay? What a half burpee means, we're down in a squat. Here, jump back, jump in. Stay in your squat, and then you're gonna take a side step or two over. Down, back, in. That's the move. Half burpee. Tap back, tap back, tap in, tap in. Never reach into the sky. Stay in the squat and move laterally two to three steps. Are you yawning? That's just oxygen. You need oxygen. All right, are you ready? We're almost done, I think. Squat, half burpee, fall forward. Jump back or tap back, 1 foot at a time. Stay in your squat. Move over in a side squat. Down, back, in. I'm taking three steps over. Down, back, in, and rest. We got it? We got the modifications? Can't do the burpee right now, fine. Two squats. Walk over, walk over. Two squats and walk over. That's gonna be our modification. Half burpees. Stay low. My legs are on fire again. I tried to work legs, chest, or legs, upper body, just to give you a rest, just to give you a rest. Ready? Go. Out, in. Walk. Walk. Down. Out, in. Walk. Walk. Modification. Squat. Squat. Stay low. Step over. I wish we could have bands. Bands would make it burn so much more. But we said no equipment. If you're at home, you totally can wrap the band above the knees for more intensity. Oh, let's go. Now, back and in. Level up. I think this is the time we need it. We're starting to fatigue. We want to quit. It's a hard move, so we want to stop. Don't stop. Quitting is not an option. Rest. Air high five, Greg. Ready? Walk. I'm taking 3 steps to the side. Count in. Air high five to you too. Ready? And let's go down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. How we doing? I am finding it difficult to continue to coach and do this one. But remember, you can modify the moves. Okay, and still get a good workout. Remember, double squat, pause, and step to the side. Double squat, pause, stand to the side. Or you can stand here and do all half burpees. Who wants to do that? Somebody up here. Greg, do I still have you? Greg. Let's go. Level up. This is my alarm clock now. I wake up to see Era singing level up. But it's like every day. How can we raise the level? Even for this week, for me, getting off the sofa and getting away from Netflix and Hulu and moving. Breath, air high fives. That was tough. So you're like, can we take a break?
Yeah.
We're gonna move into abs. Okay, let me show you some options for your ab move. With force, you can catch the heels here. Okay, use momentum, catch the heels. Or knee ends, okay? Or single leg knees, okay? Sound good? Also, here. You can do cross, okay? So all abs, cool, build the bottom. 3, 2, 1, heel catches, here. Use the arms, catch the heels. I am coming all the way up. You don't have to come all the way up. You can leave the back on the floor, bring the knees in. You can come here, do the ends, or cross. All ways to still work the core. Ready? Greg, are we still friends? Yes? I modified it here. Like 3 knee ends on each side. Still getting ab workout, okay? We're here to show, again, all levels of intensity so everyone can feel a challenge. Here. Can you touch your heels? Can you touch the ankles? It's hard, especially as we fatigue. If you find yourself slipping, like me, you need a break. Break down to crunches. I keep showing you options because I want to keep you engaged. I don't want you to stop. Rest right now. Good, here we go. I'm going to do the knees. Greg is doing a bicycle crunch. Remember, I told you to do all those options. Knees. single leg at the end. Few reps on each side. I gotta tell you guys, I was the first class on the schedule. I didn't want to make it too easy for you. Let's go. Lift the shoulders and the tailbone if you can. If you're taking a modified option, if you can. Remember, come all the way up. My abs won't even let me come up anymore. Hang in there, we're almost done. We have yoga coming up too. You guys can stay tuned for that. A good way to stretch out of it. Let's go. Are your abs on fire? Yes? No? Great? Talk to me.
I'm frozen.
Keep it going, guys. Last one. Oh, I lied. One more. Okay, just one more, y'all. I promise. And let's go. Somebody out there is like, we're so glad to see Angel struggling. Revenge, Angel. Rest, guys. Listen, so we're done with Tabata, but we do have a couple of things. We do have a couple of things to do that I like to do to finish off our strength work, okay? And we'll do it in sets of reps. We'll do it in reps, okay? So the first thing is I like to do the bird dog plank. The bird dog plank, and it can be in on the knees or on the toes. I am totally going to do it on the knees, okay? Because it still doesn't work out that way. And you're here on all fours, wrists underneath the shoulders, knees underneath the hips. Opposite arm, opposite leg, okay? You're here. If we can do right and left equals one, 10 reps, okay? What does it look like on the toes? You're in a plank here, opposite arm, opposite leg. Okay, still making sure you don't drop the head and you keep a straight head neck alignment. Are you ready? Right and left equals one, we're gonna do 10 reps. And let's go. And this is one, and two, squeezing the glutes, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Good. Perfect. Sit back. We have one more for, I like to train the back, the lower back end, those muscles between the shoulders and the hips. And it's a salute. Toes are glued to the floor. Fingertips to the temple. We call it the salute. We lift the chest. Pulse up for two and then airplane for two. That's one rep. Two salutes, two airplanes, 10 reps. Ready? Leg control. Pulse for two. Salute. Lift for two. Airplane. That's one. Arms up. That's two. Squeeze the glutes. Squeeze the hamstrings. I'm on three. This is four. Strengthening our posterior chain. I'm on five, we're halfway. Six. Seven. Eight. behind. Last one. And 10. Guys, go ahead and come into a child's pose. Sit back. Yeah. Wrists under the shoulders, knees under the hips, draw belly button in, round through the spine. Good, relax. Okay. That's the program workout we have for you right now. As a challenge to you, and everybody has phones or some type of timer, I challenge you to go into your phone and set your phone for a 2-minute timer. Okay, when we are offline, you can do this at home, grab the whole family. Find a wall. Have a seat against the wall, shoulders against the wall, butt against the wall, legs parallel to the floor. Do a 2-minute wall sit. 2-minute wall sit. Then a 2-minute plank. So 2-minute wall sit, 2-minute plank. Grab a friend, Zoom somebody, FaceTime somebody, and challenge each other and do that, okay? Sounds good? We're gonna cool down a few, and then yoga's next. Sounds good? All right, thank you. Thank you. Greg, anything you wanna add?
Nope, just we're getting clean equipment.
All right. Hi guys, good job everybody. Don't forget that challenge. Do that later, let me know how it goes. Place the hands on the floor. Feet come close together, separate the knees, sit back into a child's pose. Breathe breath into the body. Inhale and exhale. Perfect. We're gonna come into a seated hurdler stretch. That front knee is bent 90 degrees. Back knee bent, open up the hips. Chest lifted, hinge over, walk the hands out. Some of you are way more flexible than me, and that's fine. And you can straighten that back leg and come into an extended pose. Feel a release through the glutes. Good. Oh, we're gonna do a swing the legs around to the other side. And these are really good moves for hip mobility too. So just swinging the knees around and opening up the hips. Our good mobility exercises. Good. Go ahead and release. Come on up. We're going to come on to the knees. Bring one knee forward. Hips are square. We're going to lean forward. Hip flexor stretch. The knee that's down, that arm comes up. Reach for the sky. Now lean to the side of the bent knee. Good. Come back to the center. Take the hand that's lifted. Bring it over the opposite knee and just twist. Look over the shoulder and look towards those fingertips. Good, back to the center. That foot that's down. Heel down, toe up, chest lifted and just hinge over. Try to bring the chest to the knee. If you can take those fingertips to the floor, reach for the toe. Feel a stretch through the hamstring and the calf. Good, bring that leg around. Back to the other side. Hip flexor, here, square, arm up, lean to the side. Good, we're back to the center, twist. That hand comes over opposite knee. Reach and look towards the fingertips. You can extend that arm and look towards those fingertips as an extended stretch. Good, back to the front. Heel down, toe up. Hinge over, reach towards the floor, feel a stretch through the hamstring and the calf. You're gonna have half the burn from this workout. Tabata style training, bring that leg in. Let's go ahead and roll up one vertebrae at a time. It is an excellent fat burner, but not only that, it continues to burn longer after the workout is over. Quad stretch, knees together, heel towards the butt. Elongate the quadricep. Good. Switch legs, other side. Balance. Take the foot that's in your hand and bring it behind the standing foot. Lean over. IT stretch. And then we're going to take the leg around to the other side. Reach in the direction of the back foot. Take the hands, one hand over the other. Separate the shoulder blades, look towards the floor. Feel a stretch through the upper back. Still breathing heavy. And then open up the chest. Turn the thumbs down. Now take those hands. One hand over the other. Press the chest out. Roll the shoulders back. Give yourself a hand and we're done. Yoga's next. Okay? We're gonna get set up for that. Alright? Thank you guys.
Finish?
Yes, ma'am.